Stock Jockey here for HotStockMarket.com, and this is the anatomy of a pump and dump. Let me start off by saying that not all pump and dumps are intentional. Sometimes these are real companies that do have direction and do have a real business, but some things go wrong. That's just part of life. Businesses do fail, and most of the time, the charts will look the same. So we're going to take a look at a chart in a second. This does not only apply to penny stocks, in fact, this applies to all stocks, be it Briex or Enron even. The story is always the same and the stock charts are always the same, so let's jump into it. This probably looks complicated, but let me break it down for you one step at a time. It always starts the same way, and that is, in the beginning, there's some stock, no one really cares about it much, but some people know about it, and they start accumulating and buying shares. Then some event takes place. The stock pops up, and the excitement starts spreading to the boards. And you can see the smiley guy, because people are getting excited now. Then some other news event happens, and the stock spikes even higher. It goes up 50, 100, 200%. Now people are really excited about it. And here comes the fun. There's the promise of a press release, the promise of some event. It happens and the stock explodes. And we're talking a huge move. And it's always, always on huge volume. New investors get caught in this spike each and every time. A lot of investors are on the sidelines and they are watching. And when they see this move up here, they just get excited and they jump in because they think the stock is going to go higher. The dancing banana comes out, the booyah signs come out. Then, all of a sudden, bam, it drops. Why? Well, all these people here who got in the stock early are taking their profits, and rightly so. I always tell people, take profits when you can, lock them in. New investors are often left wondering what the hell happened here, and confusion gets even worse as the stock keeps dropping. At this point, we usually get these guys who were involved in early on telling everyone to be cool about it, not to worry. At this point, you should not be listening to what people say. All you gotta do is look at the chart, because everything you need to know is being told to you right here. There is an important support level. If the stock breaks through that, something is wrong. It is not working out, regardless of what this guy says. And before you know it, the stock broke under support, and you are starting to get really sad. And as another support level is broken, that sadness turns into anger. And soon, as the stock drops even more, that anger turns into fighting. Now we always have this. It's the longs and the bashes, and they start going at it. At this point, the moderators at HSM are rolling their eyes because they've seen this 1,000 times before. And this is actually one of the saddest and one of the funniest parts of each and every pump and dump, because without fail, it always happens. And let's zoom into another screen here for a second. All right, this is what happens. The members are arguing and fighting. It's the longs versus the bashers. The moderators read all this exchange, and there's usually a lot of profanity involved, and they start banning people. Then there's always the conspiracy nut who suddenly decides that the moderators must be part of the conspiracy, because if they ban someone who is bashing the stock, they're trying to hide the truth. Or if they ban someone who was long on the stock, they're also trying to hide the truth. And as you can see, this is an actual webcam image of what that person looks like. The moderators reading this are yawning by now and rolling their eyes because they've seen this 100 times before. The rest of us are laughing because we've also seen this all the time. And life goes on, days turn into weeks and weeks into months. The people still involved are so emotionally scarred. I don't know who these people are, but they keep on beating the dead horse, and the rest of us are just watching and eating our popcorn. And as you can see, the stock starts going down into oblivion, and at some point, it does the usual reverse split, ticker change, rinse and repeat. And the whole time, the experienced investors watch this and are just thinking, oh, those poor Kool-Aid drinkers, because we see it all the time. And now that you have seen it, you know exactly what to watch out for. And that is the anatomy of the pump and dump. Stock Jockey, out. Actually, not out, not yet. Just one more thing I have to throw in there before we sign off on this anatomy of a pump and dump, and that is this. If this is you, this sad guy, or if this is you, the angry red guy, or if these guys are you, or if you're this guy beating the dead horse with little flies flying around his nose and little cute X's for eyes, if this guy is you, there's basically two things you can do. One, eat the loss and move on. There are plenty other investments out there, and now that you know what a pump and dump looks like, you know what to avoid. Or two, you can probably stay in the stock, but statistically, the odds are against you that you will ever get your money out of this. I would say 1 in 30, if not 1 in 50 of these stocks, which go through a pattern like this, maybe they end up changing business direction, or some deal does come through and something may happen. It doesn't happen often, but it does happen. Not all the time, though. So if you're any of these guys, those are your options. Eat the loss, move on with your life. And if this is you, if you just put 1/10 of the effort that you put into beating this dead horse,